Let's start coding a little bit. Here, we have another plugin, another static plugin called com.cms macro. Internally, what it does is to create a velocity macro that we are going to use, or we are going to install as a static plugin, and then we will use that macro in a page. Please open the file macros XVM that you have under plugin seeds static com.cms macro conf. And if you want to go ahead, you can copy that file here under com.cms training conf. All right, guys. Well, meanwhile, for those that have already copied the macros XVM file, let's compile. Our environment again. Okay, and then when the command finishes, let's move to our Tomcat 8 bin folder and run the .startup.sh command. What we see here on this macro, this is a velocity code that just declared a method called hello world that internally is going to print hello world macro. I'm going to check if everything is okay with my environment. Okay. And now it is indexing the content the first time. Okay. And what I am going to do now is to create a new content. Specifically, I'm going to create a page asset. I click on Add New Content, Page Asset. Oh, let's do them better using the site browser. I think it's easier. We can go to Site, Browser. We can create a new folder here. Now we can call it Training. Click on Save. Then here, and click on Page. I give it a title, and I'm going to use a blank template. Click on Save and Publish. And once here, I click on the Edit tab to add a new simple widget. By default, it will list all the widgets I have already created in my environment, but I want to create a new one, so I click on the plus, simple widget, give it a name, and here I'm going to paste this code. What it does is to internally invoke my velocity macro. As I said, the velocity macro here is hello world, so I am invoking this macro here. If I click save and publish, if you see now, it says hello world macro. If we see it, it is printing the same information I had typed here. Now let's see a better example, but I'm going to use something similar, but using Vue Tools. We prefer to use Vue Tools instead of Velocity Macro for performance reason and also for security reason. That's because when you use a Vue tool, you have your Java code, and you can handle the logic that you want the page execute. But when you use a velocity macro can be installed, for example, for an end user in your environment. And if you don't know what that velocity macro does internally, it can be a security leak that you can leave in another hand. So that's why we prefer to use a Vue tool to simulate the same scenario. What am I going to do here? Under plugin seats static, there is an example called con.cms view tool. Internally, under source con.cms view tool, there is a Java file called hello view tool. Please copy this hello view tool Java from the plugin seats path, and you can copy this under your con.cms training package, the one that we have in our development environment, and you should see something like this. The path is source main plugins con.cms training, and there is a folder source,
yep,
con.cms training, and there you have to copy the hello view tool. That hello view tool Java class only has a hello method that returns a string with a message. a very simple class. If we go to the plugin sits static conduct CMS view tool, also there is a conf folder. There is a file called toolbox.xxml.
Mm-hmm.
This file has a key that is the name that you give to the view tool in your page. So it works like the instance name. When you want to use the view tool in a page, you have to reference the view tool using Hello World, as I define here. This is the scope or this variable, and this is the class that contains what this variable is going to run. So if you look at, we are going to copy that file, the conduct.cms view tool conf toolbox.xxml under our conf folder of our conduct.cms training project. And also that is important to consider, guys, please, if we are using another package here, please be aware that the package name is conduct.cms training. It applies the same here for the Java file. The package mm-hmm. has to be conduct.cms training, because if we don't do that, we will have a compilation problem. Once you do that, guys, please stop the server using the dot shutdown command. Recompile your environment again using the Gradle W deploy where Tomcat. And please, guys, if you are following me, and you are using the Postgres database, please recreate the database, because if you don't have as we are removing the dot security folder and the assets folder when we run the deployware Tomcat, if you don't clean the database, we will have problem when we want to start the server again. When you run the deployware Tomcat, the root folder that you have under Tomcat will be recreated, and it will remove everything you have there, unless you configure a .secure folder and an asset folder outside as an external path. You can do that using your using the .marketing configuration file. Let me show you the documentation where you have find more information about there is a under dot marketing config properties, there is a property file, and there is a property key called asset path. And also mm-hmm. there is a key called asset real path. By default, if you don't specify an asset real path, it will install an asset folder under the Tomcat web app root directory. But if you define one, for example, suppose that you want to install your assets under documents, under home users, your name documents, you have to define here the new path. That's for the asset real path folder. But if you want to modify the .secure where your indexes and cache information will be stored, you need to modify this file. Here. Well, it's not here the property, but there is a property called es.path.home where you have to define the path where you want to store your Elasticsearch configuration. Let me see if I can find a file where I did it. Okay, perfect. Here I have one. If you look at this file, I defined a path for my assets and a dynamic content path for my .secure folder. This is under the .marketing config properties. I'm going to share this information with you guys here, because I don't have it in any slide. Okay. That's the most relevant thing that you have to modify. And also, here, for the dot mark, the dot CMS. And .cms config cluster dot properties. You have to modify the ES path home. This is a configuration you should modify in case you want to use an external Elasticsearch configuration and external assets configuration and .secure configuration. Generally, you modify the ES path home when you want to configure an external Elasticsearch. If you don't do that, the application is going to use the embedded version one. But if you don't want to recreate the database every time to run the deploy Wartomcat, I suggest to create an external asset folder, an external .secure folder, and you just have to specify in the .marketing config properties an asset real path and a dynamic content path. So in that case, you don't have to worry about your database anymore, except when you want to clean everything out. So going back to our example, if you finish compiling your source code, and if you started the server again after recreating your database, please, if you haven't done yet, start the server using the debug parameter in order to debug our Java class. I am going to put a breakpoint here. And while the server is starting up, I'm going to configure a remote debugging here. If you are in the IDE, if you are on this window, debug configuration, you can click here under the remote Java application, and it will create a new configuration for you. There, if you don't have it by default, you can change the port. We use the 8000 port, and you can let the host as it is, local host. Give it a name. And in the source code, please click on Add and select a Java project. And here, the list of all your Java projects that you have imported in your IDE will appear. Please select the .cms file. And it should appear here. And for debugging, you just have to configure a remote Java application here. And for the source, you just have to select the Java project, the .cms5 Java project.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now let's wait a little bit for Steve. Okay, what I'm going to do now is here on site browser, training, create a new page. I'm going to call it view tool page. I'm going to select a blank page, save and publish. And then I'm going to edit that page to add a new simple widget. Click on the plus, simple widget. Let's call it view tool widget. And look at this code. Here I am defining, I'm setting the key that I had defined here in my toolbox XML. As you remember, this key should match this here with the dollar sign. And then after the dot, I'm going to call the hello method that I defined in my Hello View Tool class. Click on Save and Publish. And automatically it tries to execute my code. For some reason, guys, my debugging perspective crashed. Let me see if it's working again. Okay, it is working. It is working now. As you see, I modified the message with a hot replacement without restarting the server, and the new message appeared here.